YidLife Crisis is a Yiddish comedy web series focusing on the Jewish culture, created by Ellie Battalion and Jamie Elman.
I was fortunate enough to have a quick chat with actor Jamie Elman about YidLife Crisis and much more. He's best known for the starring role as Cody on the hit sitcom Student Bodies. He has also worked on many other critically acclaimed TV shows such as Mad Men, Criminal Minds and Curb Your Enthusiasm.
How did you meet Ellie?
Ellie was 4 years younger than me at my high school.
Okay.
And so we went to the same high school, and I had vaguely heard about him because he was part of a hip-hop comedy duo with another guy in his grade who, and they actually were quite successful at it. They played at the Just for Laughs Festival in Montreal. And it's funny, it's, you know, two white, short, Jewish guys doing hip-hop, but they're, like, actually brilliant, and they were great.
Yeah.
And so they had some success doing that, and then eventually, many years later, like about 10 years ago now, I think it is, maybe 12 years ago, Ellie and this other guy came to L.A. to do a version of their hip-hop show, one of their hip-hop shows,
yeah,
which is a play. And I went to see the play because I knew these guys were from my high school, whatever, and I went to see it, and they were both brilliant, and that's when I knew that I wanted to work with them, and so I ended up befriending both of them and eventually working with both of them.
Okay, and whose idea was it to start YidLife Crisis between the two of you?
Whose idea? Well, basically, this third guy that I was just mentioning, his old partner, me and the other guy did a web series together.
Okay.
Which you can check out. It's called Crazy, Sexy, Awkward.
Ben.
Hi.
Oh. Hi. Hello. Hey. Oops.
Let's go. Get dressed.
No, you guys.
No. You're coming with us.
I can't. I have a ton of shit to do.
Name one thing you have to do.
Banking.
5 o'clock on a Sunday. Banking.
Online. Banking.
Dude! You have been locked up in this man cave way too long. We gotta get you back out there. Break the seal.
Break a seal?
Yes. Ben hasn't had sex for a year.
And it has nothing to do with Yiddish or Jewishness per se. It's about a guy who broke up with his girlfriend, hasn't gotten laid in a year, get back out into the world of dating after he's been, like, alone and miserable for a long time. And the... was in LA like while we were working on it, and he enjoyed it, and he was like, we should do a web series together, and we were looking for something to do together. And then basically the Jewish Federation in Montreal,
yeah,
which is called Federation CJA, which is basically the main philanthropic organization, Jewish organization in Montreal,
mm-hmm,
basically just said, do whatever you want. Here's a little bit of money. Do whatever you want, as long as it's Jewish and artistic. Try and make it something that reaches out to the non-Jewish world in some way. They talked about the word rapprochement, which means, rapprochement, whatever that word is in English, which is basically, try and community bridge building.
Yeah.
And so we came up with the idea, we said, so that's when he called me and said, let's do something together.
Okay.
In Yiddish.
Another thing I wanted to mention is stereotypes. Have you ever had any backlash from other Jews that kind of thought you're kind of making them look bad?
Fair question. The truth is basically no. We don't, I understand why you're, our whole thing is, you know, it's a love letter to Judaism. It's just we're poking fun of it by, that we are poking fun at Jewishness because we love our Jewishness by pointing out all these things. But actually there's been virtually no backlash to the show, to any episode. Yeah, there's been a couple of episodes or a couple jokes that people, you know, might think we took it too far or whatever, but for the most part, Jews recognize themselves in the show. And I also like to think that non-Jews who see the show maybe also recognize their own versions of these hypocrisies.
Have you ever thought about teaching people about it in your spare time?
Well, yes, I did teach part-time Hebrew in LA for a bunch of years and Judaic. I taught kids in LA as a part-time job, as many actors take part-time jobs in LA. That was my part-time job, teaching Hebrew, teaching bar mitzvah. And I've always been, we call ourselves closeted Jewish educators. we actually do like teaching people, but we also like to use YidLife as a Trojan horse. We say we use the Trojan horse of comedy to teach people. Other cheesy words we use, edutainment.
Oh, nice. I like that.
We like to teach people through the web series. We like to find ways of letting people laugh at the show,
yeah,
and only realize later that they've actually learned something, if possible. Like, the main goal of the show is to be funny,
yeah,
but also we do try and imbue each episode with things that will, you know, teach people new concepts,
yeah,
including Jews. Including Jews. We hear from Jews all the time that they learned a new thing about, you know, and a certain aspect of the holiday or about whatever from episodes, even though we're just making jokes about it, you know. So I like to think that education is part of the show.
Okay, cool.
Although we have talked to places like Columbia University.
Oh, wow, wonderful.
Educational. Yeah, we do want to partner up with a more official academic curriculum for YidLife. We haven't done it yet, but that's on the card.
So I just wanted to ask, would you be talking or discussing what happened recently with the whole, you know, the shootings in the synagogue? Is that something you would be bringing up in YidLife Crisis, or is that something you'd rather avoid on YidLife Crisis?
Look, that is a great question, Sue. You know, it's a good question. It's a tough thing to us. There's not much that we can contribute to the conversation that hasn't been said by people smarter than us, rabbis, educators, and whatever.
Yeah.
But I will say that if anything, it encourages us in a way more than ever to educate people about, you know, what Judaism is and what Jews are. I mean, that was one of our original ideas behind the show, was we want to show the non-Jewish world what Jews are like, and in particular, we want to show the French Canadians in Montreal about Jews like us, because in if you watch the first season of YidLife, you see the show takes place in a part of Montreal where there are ultra-Orthodox religious Jews walking around, black hats, right?
Yeah.
And you watch our season 1, episode 3, called Great Debates. We're talking about them. And the thing is, they live in this part of Montreal where they are right on top of the French Canadians and the non-Jews there. They're not out in I forget, in London, where is it, Hampstead Heath or something?
Yeah.
You know, it's not like that. They're in the middle of the city with everybody else. And it's caused tension over the years. And so one of the things that we wanted to do at the beginning of the show is to show the non-Jews that we are also Jews, and we are not extremists.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. We are, in some ways, we're separating ourselves from the ultra-Orthodox community and saying we know that that's extreme, but we're not all extremists.
Mm-hmm.
We come in every different color, shape, size. I mean, people don't understand that, not that we look particularly non-Jewish, mm-hmm. but there are black Jews, there are Asian Jews, mm-hmm. there are Indian Jews, there are Jews. Jews are not a race.
Yes.
So Jews can look like everything, and Jews also practice Judaism in all ways, from the black hats to being atheists.
Mm.
And we can still be Jewish in different ways,
yeah.
And we can be part of the modern society in meaningful ways.
In season 3, will we be expecting any special guests? Because you have had Mayhem and you've had Howie Mandel, so are there any more that we can expect to see?
We, you know what? Great, fair question. We have a wish list of lots of people we want to work with. It's, I don't have any names I can name drop with you right now, but I will say that we're working on a couple, and we also just have episodes that are a bit more production heavy that we've been excited about. We want to do like in locations in Montreal and stuff like that. So I can tell you, or I'll give you a sneak. This is not as exciting as Maya or Howie. Like, for example, our next episode that's coming out is called Autoneurotic. That's true. And the episode takes place in a car. Now, that's not exciting for, you know, like, celebrity reasons, but for us, we've never shot an episode in a car before. So, like, that'll be something. So we're trying to do new things in the production that will keep it fresh.
Yeah.
If we can get another, you know, star appearance, we're definitely going to try to do that.
Are there any that you would, like, any on your wish list that you'd like to have?
Oh, my God, we have many on our wish list. You know Sarah Silverman?
Oh, yes, of course.
You know, Howard Stern, we have a lot.
What's the process that you go through with Ellie to write the next episode and, you know, just what's that like?
Well, you know, we have a whole list of sort of things that we want to talk about in... that topics that we think touch us and touch our audience, you know.
Yeah.
So we would sort of start with an idea. For example, the idea for the episode that we are, well, for the first episode, Sue Cannabis, it was like we want to do a Sukkot episode because that's the holiday of Sukkot was coming up when we were going to release it.
Mm-hmm.
We've done other episodes about holidays like Rosh Hashanah and mm-hmm. Yom Kippur. So we wanted to sort of try one that was, you know, maybe a less known holiday to sort of educate people about that.
Yeah.
And it happened to be coming out the same month that Canada legalized marijuana. and we wanted to draw some things about, you know, getting high and, you know, the high holidays and
mm-hmm.
being in a spiritual, enlightened place and stuff like that.
I saw that in season 3.
Yes. one, for example, that Autoneurotic came from a discussion we had that was Jews not buying German product. And I don't know if you've ever heard that concept, but there are a lot of conservative Jews, usually traditional Jews, who still to this day won't buy German-made product in protest of the Holocaust, or basically, you know, because it reminds them of the Holocaust.
Yeah.
But this is very YidLife Crisisian, we say. It's very much the crisis because Germany has paid tons of reparations to Israel. All the cars there are German cars. Well-to-do Jews all over the world buy German cars. And, you know, you could make the argument that, you know, Germany tends to vote with Israel. So basically, it's a good example of the crisis. So we'll start with an idea like that. And then we'll try and take it to an extreme place. So it's like, imagine if you don't buy German, you also don't buy Japanese. Any of the Axis powers, and it starts to be this, you know, thing.
Yeah.
So basically, we start with that, and then we sketch out all the beats of the ideas of the jokes or the ideas of the concepts that we want to get across.
Mm-hmm.
And then one of us writes a first draft that based on sort of a beat sheet, and then we pass it back and forth and just keep tweaking it up. We write it with an eye to the Yiddish and the translation that's going to come in. We write even with jokes in the Yiddish embedded into the script, so we know it's going to be this line and there's going to be a joke there for the people who speak Yiddish and stuff like that. And then we work with the Yiddish translator who gives us many different ways of saying the lines, and we work with her to make sure it all is going to line up, and then we shoot it, and then we still have another chance to work with the Yiddish because in the subtitles now,
mm-hmm.
what I'm about to do when the editor gets here is still tweak the subtitles, tweak the Yiddish and ADR where you can replace dialogue. So we keep writing until we finish the episode. we take it very
seriously.
Yeah.
And what should we expect? What should the fans expect in 3?
We're like you saw already with Sue Cannabis, you know, we're trying to be a little bit edgier, a little bit. In season we were switching between Yiddish and English a bit more.
Yeah.
A lot of our
I noticed that.
Which is good for the non-Jews, and it's good for the Jews who don't love reading subtitles that much, but the truth is our hardcore fans want more Yiddish, and we're just going to do a bit more I don't want to say edgy comedy, but we have some ideas that are maybe going to be a little bit more like Sue Cannabis was, a little bit more, ooh, they're going to... No, I don't know. So I don't know. Stay tuned. We think we were cooking up some good stuff.